Dive teams go into the Milwaukee River searching for a missing Milwaukee man.
And 24-year-old Nick Wilcox was last seen between 1 and 2 a.m. on Tuesday. 12 News' Nick Bohr live where police have been looking. And Nick, they went into the water today because of their sonar equipment.
That's right, and they were detecting something under the ice here on the Milwaukee River, and since they hadn't turned up many leads into the whereabouts of Nick Wilcox, they thought they'd take a look. The search going on for 2 days along the Milwaukee River took a grim overtone when Milwaukee police divers decided to take a first-hand look under the frozen surface. 12 News has learned a man who owns a canoe tied up along Old World 3rd Street in Juneau called police when he said he was breaking up ice around the canoe and saw some ice he thought didn't look right. The dive team broke up that ice and sent down a sonar device that detected several objects along the bottom, prompting them to actually go into the water several hours later. They found only a very old cell phone, some chairs, and even a shopping cart, but no sign of Nick Wilcox.
He gets a little goofy once in a while, but we all do, you know, and he'd give you the shirt off his back if you asked for it, you know. Unfortunately, something must have set him off.
Wilcox's family is heading up dozens of volunteers, posting flyers and trying anything to get clues to his disappearance.
Oh, we've had tremendous support. Kelly, my brother's girlfriend, and her family, and just a ton of friends of Kelly's and Nick's. I have some of my friends coming down soon, and I mean, we've just had tons of help.
Nick's father says even the management and staff at the bar where he was last seen have helped with the search.
Oh, they did nothing wrong. My son's an adult. He's responsible for what he does, and I just like to get him back.
Now, the Wilcox family says they've been told that he was seen at a Qdoba on Water Street, which is, of course, across the river from here, about 3 in the morning on New Year's Day. They're hoping that can be verified through some videotape from that store, and perhaps that could lead to some new clues as to his whereabouts. Reporting live along the Milwaukee River, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.